Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to style this hero image, complete with the gradient button and this logo here. So let's get straight into it. I'm going to be using the Scrimber IDE. This just allows me to get started with zero setup. You can check it out at scrimber.com. I'm going to get started with the HTML. So it's already got the style sheet linked and I'm going to add a section for the class of, you've guessed it, hero. And then I'm going to add a paragraph with a class of logo. And that's the name of the shop, which is Boutique. And I'm going to add my H1. Next we need the button, which I'll give a class of BTN and a type of button. And finally, if we look at the design, there's a small delivery text at the bottom, which is another paragraph, which I'm going to inventively call delivery text. So really, that's the only thing I need for my HTML, except this font that the entire hero uses is a Google font called Merryweather. I'm going to add the 400 and the 700 and link that before the style sheet. And one more thing, actually, Bespoke Flowers is bold, whereas the rest of the H1 isn't. So go to wrap that in a strong tag, but that won't show up yet because by default, the H1 is already bold, so it doesn't look any different. But we're going to fix that shortly. So onto the CSS. Scrimber by default loads the reset margin and padding on the HTML and the body. So that's nice, don't have to worry about that. Then I'm going to add to the body the font weight of 400, which is the default anyway, but it's good to add it in case someone else has got some strange setting going on, which would render it differently to what you want. And then my font family. And then I'm going to add some letter spacing of a pixel, which just, as you'd expect, spread things out slightly. But you'll see that the button hasn't inherited these styles. So to get around that, I'm going to add button right here. Now I'm going to get on with adding the background image. So just added a folder called images, and then with Scrimber, I'm able to just drag and drop the file into it. And to add a background image, I first need to add a position relative to the hero, and then come down, add a before pseudo element with a position of absolute and empty content, and then add the background image with URL to the file path that I need. And then we do top of 0 pixels, right of 0 pixels, bottom of 0 pixels, and finally left of 0 pixels. So you'll see that has now loaded the image, but obviously that's not the size we want. So to fix that, background size, cover. Now, to make sure that it covers the viewport as we want, we go up to the hero element and we do height of 100 viewport height, and we do width of 100%. But now you'll see we only have the top part of the image, basically. So to rectify that, we do background position, center. Now we have these lovely flowers in the middle of our image. We do have this gap at the top here, which if I open DevTools, is caused by the logo. So to fix that, we just do logo with a margin of 0. No more gap. Now those of you with keen eyes will have noticed that the supposed background image is actually on top of everything else. So to fix that, we do Z index minus 1. And now we're back in business. Next, I'm going to work on the positioning of everything. I'm going to use flexbox on that. So we do display flex. Obviously, we want flex and flex direction column. And then to spread everything out vertically, justify content space between. But we also want everything to be centered horizontally. And to do that, we do align items center. And while I'm here, I'm going to add the color of white. When you do a background image, you should also do a background color, just in case the image doesn't load for whatever reason. So looking at this, I think I'll probably choose a nice orange color. And to find out which one to use, I've got this Chrome extension called Eyedropper. So you can just select a color from the web page, and then it'll tell you what it is here, which is this one. So if the image doesn't load, it would look like this, but I actually think that's possibly a bit too light because there isn't much contrast between the text and the image. So to get around that, I'm going to go HTML color picker and choose a slightly darker shade. So now it would look like that. Okay, I'm going to work on this H1 now. I'm just going to mark my typography in the CSS file. I'm going to give it a max width of 50% and a border of 3 pixels solid white. I'm going to soften those corners with border radius 5 pixels. Obviously, the text at the moment is very close to that border, so I'm going to add some padding of 1em on the top and bottom and 2em on the left and right. But you'll see it doesn't currently look equal on each side, and the reason for that is it's not center aligned. So to fix that, I'm going to come up on the body. I'm going to do text align center. So now it's nicely in the middle. But we do want this bespoke flowers to be bold and the rest of it to not be. So to do that, as bespoke flowers is already in a strong tag, I am going to just add a font weight of 400 to the h1. There we go. I've also realised that I need to change the delivery text slightly to say, well, not slightly, same day delivery. I'm going to style the button now, and to make this cool gradient effect, I do background image, linear gradient, and the direction I want it to go is to the right, and the colours I've used are just standard colour names, actually, and they're purple and orange. However, background image isn't going to load for everyone, so you should have a backup background, and I'm going to choose this purple, so that if the background image doesn't load, we still have contrast there. Next, I'm going to set my width of 30%, and I'm going to add some padding of 1.2em on the top and bottom, and 2em on the left and right. When you make a button, you should always have more padding on the left and right than the top and bottom. And a font colour of white, but now I've realised I've got colour white in the button and colour white in the hero. So rather than do that, I'm going to remove that and put it up here where we've selected our body and our button in one. And we're going to take off the default border with border none. Now this button is pretty rounded, so to do that, I'm going to do border radius 20 pixels. And the gradient isn't showing because I've declared the backup color below it. So I'll move that up and it's back. And to make the uppercase, I'm going to just add text transform uppercase. And that's it for the button, but my final design, I have this cool hover effect where the colors switch sides. So I'll add that next. Button hover. I'm going to do the same for the focus state so that if people are tabbing through, they'll be able to see where they are. I like to add a cursor pointer, and then it's just the same syntax for the gradient, but with the colors the other way around. So orange and purple. Let's have a look at that. Away we go. Woohoo! I love it. That is just so funky. And another thing I like to do in most of my projects actually is add a button active transform scale 0.96. And what this does is gives a satisfying button clicking effect. How nice is that? Yeah, so we are seriously getting there, but one thing we haven't worked on yet is the logo. So let's do that now. We've already got our logo selector declared in the CSS from when we got rid of that margin. So I'm going to add the same gradient we have on here. So obviously that's now added it to the background, which is not quite what we want. So we will do background clip, text, WebKit, background, text, and then WebKit, text fill, color, transparent. So you see that has now added the gradient into the text, which is very exciting. Well, I want the font size to be bigger, so I'm going to add font size 2rems. But as you'll see, the letter spacing is much narrower. So I'm going to do letter spacing minus 4 pixels. You'll see here, we have a font weight of 700. But I'm going to add that in a separate selector because I also want it on the strong and the button. So the strong tag already has it actually, but it's good to declare it anyway. There we go. So you'll see the final thing to fix on the logo is that this E is now slightly chopped off. So to fix that, we're going to do padding with 0 on top and bottom and 0.5ms on the left and right. Now, if we look at the design, there actually is some padding above the logo and below the delivery text. But I'm going to add that on the hero to do padding of 1em. But now you'll see that there is this scrolling issue going on, and that's because it's adding the padding on top of the declared height and width. And to get around that, we do box sizing border box. And now it's taking into account the paddings and actually the margins, if we had any, into the height and width. Lovely. So that's basically it for the main styles. However, for the larger screens, I prefer the logo to be a bit bigger. So to do that, I'm going to go down to the bottom and add a media query for 600 pixels and bigger. And then I'm going to say the logo should have a font size of 3 rems. So now that's nice and big on the bigger screens. But I'm also going to increase the delivery text size slightly to 2 rems. But I don't really want the button stretching that much. So to get around that, I'm going to do button max width, and I'll do 20. So now it only gets this big. So now I have the desktop size and the mobile size, including our super funky hover state on the button. And one other thing to mention is we talked about if the gradient on the button doesn't load, we have a backup shade of purple, but we didn't have a backup shade for the hover state. So we should do that now. And I'm going to use a slightly darker purple. So now still have a nice hover and focus effect. Also, if the gradient can't load on the logo, we should have a backup color as well. And I'm going to use that same purple that's on the button. So now we don't have our gradient, we'll at least still have that. And it all contrasts nicely if our background image also doesn't load. But for now, I'll have faith that everything will load and uncomment these out. And one final thing I should do is add the picture credit at the bottom in a comment. So if you want to, you can go to this link and download this exact picture. So thank you to Annie Spratt for the lovely flower picture. So that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.